Okay, I'd like to look at direct proportion in this video. And direct proportion is simply when one value goes up, the other value also goes up, or two variables. So for example, if x was one variable, if x increases, then y will also increase. So I've got two examples of that. The first one here is a straight line. See, as x goes up, y also goes up. It doesn't have to be a straight line. We've got a nice curve here. So if we take it from zero, as x goes up, y also goes up. Now when you have these equations, they're going to be linked so that y equals kx. And the k for each different question is a constant. And the y and the x are variables. This means the y and the x will change, but this stays the same. Now, this is probably explained by a couple of questions. So I'm going to look at this. X is directly proportional to y. So in this is a very typical question from exams, and we're told here directly proportional. So we've got that magic word, directly proportional. And we're given some information. When x equals 10, y equals 25. Find an equation that connects x and y. Now, because it's direct, my first thing that I'm going to write down is this, y equals kx. So let's just write down y equals kx. They then give us two different values. When x is 10, y is 25. So let's just put that in. Y is 25, x is 10, so it's 10k. And I'm just going to find out what k is, 2.5. Okay, so because I've now got k, this is basically my equation. Y equals 2.5 x's. So my k value is 2.5. Remember that x and y are going to change. This is going to stay the same for the whole of this question. So now we can do these. Find the value of y when x equals 30. So this is y equals k, which I know is now 2.5 times 30. Now I'm just going to play safe and do this on my calculator. 2.5 times 30, which gives me 75. So y is 75. And we can work the other way. Find the value of x when y equals 80, so 80 equals 2.5 x's. So I'm going to divide both sides by 2.5. So 80 divided by 2.5 is 32. So remember that starting point. Now it's going to get slightly harder, and when it gets slightly harder, it's just the language. So I've got different letters. It doesn't always have to be x and y. So I've got p and q, but further it says the square of q, and I've got this magic word in here, directly proportional again. So find an equation that connects p and q. So I'm going to start off by saying p equals k, the square of q means q squared. So now that's my starting point. P and Q will change, but K will stay the same. So now I'm going to use these values. So 12 equals K times 6 squared, so 36. So if I divide both sides by 36, I'm going to get 1/3. So remember, this is 6 squared. So now I'm going to say that this is P equals 1/3 of q squared. And here's my equation for the rest of the question. Find the value of p when q is 9. So p equals 1/3 of 9 squared. The squared is the one that most people will forget in these questions. They'll read it quickly and not understand that they've got to do the square. So this is 27. You saw me do it on the calculator. And if we go the other way, find q when p is 75. So this time my answer, or if you like, the p is 75, 1/3 q squared. So I'm going to times both sides by 3. And I get 225. So q squared is 225. Q squared is 225. Therefore, q is 15. So the important thing to remember here is always that the starting point is y equals kx, or p equals kq, or a equals whatever. And the other thing that I have to stress is read these questions carefully and look out for things like square, square root, and cube. And if you can do that, these questions are very straightforward.